try to speak.
Oh, thank you.
Just so that hears it.
Okay. Hello?
Still quiet?
It's a little bit quiet.
Well, that's the master button. That's just gonna turn everybody up.
Oh, really? Okay. Well, that's what you told me. What's his name? Two. One forty. Okay. Everybody got it? Next one, 1, 3, 2.
Yes.
Angels, we have heard on high. 1, 3, 2.
Sweet peace singing.
136, Ward 36, 136. The first door. Praise the Lord. That's, we can have the children's program now, right?
133.
We can sing that before the, yes. Yeah, we can sing that before the message. And you have the children's program now? Are they going to sing something? Are you going to sing any special?
Yeah, come on up, Levi. You can play the violin.
I praise the Lord. Someday Solomon is going to play. He has his own violin. Thank you, Lord. Beautiful, beautiful. Thank you, Jesus. Difficult instruments, but they, you know, the best way to learn is when you are young. Praise God. Let's sing 133. Hark the herald angels sing. 133.
Sing, my God, and sinners reckon.
the Lord. Hallelujah. Before we go to the message, Brother Cephas, would you like to offer a word of prayer?
Yes.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, thank you, thank you, Jesus.
Christ, my highest heaven adore.
Amen.
Christ, the everlasting Lord.
Amen.
Born to raise the sons of light. Born to give them a second life.
Yes, Lord.
We just thank you, Lord, yes, this Lord, morning. Lord.
Hallelujah.
That we have the ability, the pleasure, the opportunity,
yes, Lord,
to have a second bite.
Yes, Lord.
We come,
Lord,
this morning, Heavenly Father, to praise you, to adore you,
yes,
to
Lord,
glorify,
Hallelujah,
you, because you have walked it to be praised.
Yes, Lord. Mm.
We say thank you, Lord. Thank you for bringing us from joining worry fights to today, Lord.
Yes.
Oh, Lord, we know the road had not been easy. There have been rockets on the road. But you promised that it will always be with us. You never told us, Heavenly Father, that the road will be easy. But we just come to say thank you.
Yes, Lord.
Thank you for this day. This is the day that you have made. Let us be glad and rejoice in
yes,
you.
Yes, yes.
We just say thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Heavenly Father,
Hallelujah,
for bringing us here today.
Yes, Lord.
There are so many who want to be in the gallery today, but they cannot be here, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Oh, there are some because they are sick this morning. There are some that are on a dying bed of reflection this morning.
Yes.
But Lord, we come to say thank you.
Thank
yes,
you,
Jesus.
Thank you,
Lord.
We present our pastor into your care.
Yes, Lord God.
Thank you, Jesus.
We say, dash him, Heavenly Father.
Jesus, yes.
Give him good health, Heavenly Father.
Yes, Lord.
And not him, Heavenly Father. Speak to your people through him, Heavenly Father. That someone today on this day who is sick will be healed.
Yes, Lord.
Oh, someone, Heavenly Father, who is sad will have joy.
Yes, Lord.
Someone, Heavenly Father, that is bereaved will be comforted.
Yes, Lord.
We present his wife to you, Lord. We say continue to strengthen her.
Yes.
Continue to give her good health.
Yes.
Guide and protect her.
Yes, Lord.
Not forgetting, Heavenly Father, my blessed family.
Yes, Lord.
Thank you.
Oh, Lord, those that are sick this morning, we say, touch Dennis this morning.
Yes, Lord.
Touch him with that touch of healing, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Be with his grandson. Oh, Heavenly Father. Joy, as he go, wherever he is this morning, Jesus, let his star shine.
Yes, Jesus.
So that his people will know that you are with him.
Jesus, yes, our God.
Be with each and every one of us. Be with the family this morning that be weak.
Yes, Lord.
Be with the family that are hungry this morning. Be with their family that are sick this morning. But we know you said bring all and leave it to your foot of your cross. We know you can take care of it.
Yes, Lord, hallelujah.
But Lord, not our will. Let your will be done. Let it be glorified. Let the angels in heaven sing this morning,
yes,
from the word that you have given your servant to tell your people this morning.
Yes,
in Jesus' precious name.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Blessed be the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You know,
Amen,
the song we sang, Hark. No, the herald, the angel sang, explaining that hark,
yes,
means hear.
Yes.
We got to hear not only the song, the message in all of them.
Yes.
There are more than 10 plus messages doctrinally sounded. Doctrinally sounded doctrines are here.
Yes.
That's the way Charles Wesley, when he wrote it, he wanted to make sure all the vital doctrines covering the entire Bible, including Revelation, Jesus will be with his healing, with his wings. It was remarkable. Hark. Hark means listen, hear, and apply it. I read the story of the Titanic. We all heard that. You know, in those days, they had what they called the wireless radio. Wireless radio. There was a ship that the captain, his name is Cyril Evans. And he radioed this Titanic about 10 minutes before and talked to this gentleman by name Jack Phillips, who was on the wireless radio at the same time. And he warned him about the iceberg. Yeah, we ran into an iceberg. Ice. We don't want you to get into that. So this Cyril, he didn't pay any attention. You know, He paid attention, but Jack didn't want to pay attention. He heard, but he was talking to all the other people, conveying their messages. And if he had listened to the message, he could have avoided getting Titanic hit the iceberg. That is the moral of the story. In 10 minutes later, the boat was sinking after hitting the iceberg. It was one of the most horrible accidents in the life of, they say, maritime life. It was the largest boat, and they thought it is the most unsinkable boat, Titanic. A lot of stories behind it. But this I thought fascinating because Jack Phillips did not hark. He did not hear. The message of Christmas is also like this. We celebrate it every year. They say it's 336, I believe, AD, December 3rd, 25. They celebrated the very first Christmas as a celebration. First celebration. And they celebrated not to say, no, look at it today. Do they say, praise the Lord, because of Christmas, right? They don't say Christmas. What is the greatest praise on Christmas? Christ himself. Christ himself is the greatest praise for the entire human race. Everybody. The message of Christmas is, listen. That Christ, the King, was born not to rule right now, but he was born as the Savior of the world to save and you me, to give you and me the second birth. That's when you apply the Word of God and listen and obey the Word of God. You know, I'm almost finishing the book of Deuteronomy. God says in that book, I am giving you all this. Hear, O Israel, hear. Shema Israel, Adonai Eloheinu. Hear, O Israel, the Lord is one. Adonai Echad, one God, and so on. Listen to him. God laid out so many rules, the commandments. Obey my commandments. I cut that word enough. The reason being for your good enough, not for anything else. I brought you through all the wilderness for your good, so that you could go to the land of milk and honey. If you continue to stay there and obey my word and don't fall into a trap of worshipping the foreign deities, foreign gods, I will bless you and you will be prosperous and everything.
Praise God.
But if you don't, these are the curses that would happen to you.
Yeah.
And we know they fell into all the traps one after the other, worshipping the foreign gods and so on, deities and so on. So God had to send them to a Babylonian captivity. And then the list goes on of all the trials and tribulations the children of Israel went through. And also on the other side, they caused trouble too. Now, when you see that in the New Testament, it is the same problem with God's people. So when Paul wrote to the Colossian church, at that time there were two different problems there. You know, the Greeks at that time believed that matter is evil. M-A-T-T-R. This is a matter. M-A-T-T-R. Matter. Anything is matter. It is.
It's evil.
We say it doesn't matter, but they say the matter is evil. Only the spirit is good. Only the spirit. So God could not become a matter. God cannot be born as a human. Can you believe this? That doctrine prevailed. So Paul is opposing that doctrine. No, that's not true. If Christ could not be born as a human being so that he could qualify to go to the cross and die for you and for me, you could never be saved. There is no other way to be saved.
Yeah.
See, no other name under heaven whereby you can be saved is given. No other name given under heaven whereby you and I can be saved. So that is the way Peter was able to hit it, hit the nail on its head. So if Christ were not born to give you and me the second birth, we haven't got the greatest prize. You know. We'll be still celebrating part of the meaning of Christmas, but not the totality of the meaning of Christmas. You know. Isn't that amazing? So the rest of the world doesn't know the other part of the message too. You know. What is that other part of the message? If they don't believe, they will be condemned. You know. Hell is out there waiting for them. And John 3:16 is so beautifully worded. God loves everybody. God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. He gave it so that whoever believes in him should not perish but have everlasting life. It will have an eternal implication if only they receive Christ as Lord and Savior. If not, the secret code there is, or it's easy to understand, it's an everlasting punishment. Isn't that amazing? Either punishment, look at the Titanic, had that punishment, you cannot avoid it. The people who did jump into the icy waters, we were talking about jumping into the pond last night, Eileen and I were talking about it. Imagine that these people were forced into the icy waters of the Atlantic and they sank. Crying, screaming. Imagine that. Oh, it was unbearable. Just imagine that. Imagine. A lot of people were pulled out of water, even during this, the past 1 week. A dog was pulled out of the icy waters. The dog was screaming. I don't know, it strayed away and fell into it. Somehow they rescued the dog. So it is not an easy matter. So during the time of the Colossians, they also believed another bad doctrine, which is God could also become an incarnate being in the sense as a spirit being in various names. In other words, very many deities could also be the possibilities. Christ is one of them. So Christ was a spirit. In the same way, there could be other deities. So Paul wanted to hit that heretical doctrine also, you know, saying that, no, only in Christ, the fullness of the Godhead, you see, live bodily, in a bodily form. You know. In other words, Christ is the only one who can have this double nature. What is it? Eternal, at the same time, corporal, eternal and human. He came as a human being, which is a miracle. Very good. We cannot understand it. It's very difficult. Mm-hmm. How could that be? You know? Body and soul are separate. You know? Body and spirit, they're all separate. And yet one person. You know? So when Christ came out, let's read the scripture in Colossians 1:15. Colossians, the book of Colossians. The book of Colossians 1, chapter 1, 15 to 17. He is the image of the invisible God. Who is the image of the invisible God? Christ. When he came as a human, even as a human, he represented the image of the invisible God. How? God is not human. In the sense, God the Father never took the human form. But Christ took the human form. So Paul is trying to assert, although you see him in the human form, Christ, he is the image of the invisible God. You know, we have to take it as the scripture puts it. You know, too much into the going into that. You know, I thought over that so many times. You know, he is the image of the invisible God. The firstborn over all creation. Firstborn over all creation. If you go into this theologically and delve deeper and deeper into it, God became a human. Or God took the form of a human. Even the Lord God got into Mary to reveal himself to the world, through the world. Now I was thinking about the theophany too. God appeared to Abraham. But Abraham did not have Melchizedek representing night and day like Jesus, 33 and a half years. That's why he's Emmanuel. He will be called Jesus to save people from their sins. But at the same time, he's going to be Emmanuel in the eternal sense. You will be always Emmanuel. Jesus said, I am with you, even unto the end of the world. They said, how could that be? They were not even 50 years old. Did he see Abraham? Yes, before Abraham was, I am. There he is talking about his eternal existence. He has been before. The first chapter of the Gospel of John talks about it. What does he talk about it? He was the beginning. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. Logos. And he was before all things. Everything he created them. Read the Gospel of John, first chapter, over and over again in this context. You will see a lot more deeper things you can see. Now, let's go on. The firstborn over all creation. He was not created, but he was begotten. He was begotten. That's why Isaiah 9:6, unto us a child is born. He had to take the form of a baby through Mary. Now what happens? After he was born, so a child was born, a son is given. That is why begotten. The firstborn over five, by him all things were created. Who is the creator? Christ is the creator. Jesus was not created. He was the one who created everything. Gospel of John, first chapter. In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. So Christ was in the Godhead bodily. And he spoke, the Spirit, Ruma. For by him all things were created that are in heaven and that are on earth, visible and invisible. Whether thrones or dominions or principalities or powers, all things were created through him and for him. Isn't that amazing? Mm-hmm. So we are created for him. And he is before all things. And in him all things consist. In him all things consist. You know, a few days ago they said, I was reading about it from the whole earth, the planet, is a little bit tilted over the axis, 23.5 degrees or something, a little above. God holds that. If it tilts more, we are in big jeopardy, big problem. So everything is held by the Lord. Everything consists. God holds everything, every planet, everything, and all the stars, everything in its place. Because he is before all things. And he, and in him all things consist. And the second scripture I want to emphasize about this whole thing is this. Turn to the second chapter of the Colossians. There's another one, very important scripture. This is the one I use always when I witness to the Jehovah Witnesses. For in him dwells all the fullness of the Godhead. How? Bodily. All the fullness of the Godhead bodily. The fullness in the Greek means pleroma, like the pleroma, everything, fullness, everything, all, the totality of the property of God. That is the twofold nature of Christ. What is the twofold? When you go into the Greek part of it, it makes much more sense to me. You call the idiomaton, idiomaton koinonia. Koinonia means communication. Idiomaton means property. What is the property? It's a nature, the nature of God, the characteristic. God became human. That is Christ. And the same Lord God, Jesus, is also eternal. He has always been in existence. One with the Father and one with the Holy Spirit. See the twofold aspects of God, the Lord God Jesus. So that is what we call the twofold nature of Jesus. So when he was born into this world, the primary focus of his birth was death. Isn't that amazing?
Yeah.
The most primary focus of his entry into the world as a human is death itself. But for his death on the cross, you and I would be alive. You and I would not be alive. That is why 1 John 3:16 talks about how John puts it together. He laid down his life for us. God laid down his life for us. How? As a human. As a spirit, he could do it. As a human, he could do it. That is why Christ is also compared to the second Adam. The first Adam was created by God. He was not God. He was created by God. He was exactly like God. He had the likeness of God because he had the life of God. Because God blew into his whole being, the nostrils, what? The breath of life. Life came from God. So he became a living soul. Who became a living soul? Adam. So Paul compares him, he's earthly. But the second Adam is not earthly. He came from heaven. He is the Lord from heaven. See the comparison? So the second Adam gave us the second birth. So he had to be born as a human with this human nature so as to fit into that puzzle. What is that puzzle? To die for the entire humanity. That is why the revelation of Jesus Christ has been considered a mystery in all ages. Can you believe that? But what is a mystery? You know, when you talk to different churches, they will say, oh, it is a mystery, we can't understand. No, Apostle Paul made it so clear. It is not a mystery anymore. Because the Lord God Jesus, the anointed King, the Messiah, the Christ, has been revealed. He is the one. He is the one. When Simeon took the baby, what did he say? Behold, my eyes have seen the salvation of God. They've been waiting for ages. Paul puts it, as at last, God has manifested himself. How? In Christ. The book of Hebrews. So if you look them, put them all together as a piece puzzle, like the kids were making a house yesterday. I watched that. All the pieces put together. All of them. And Benjamin said, the rest of it will be completed tomorrow. So that's the way when Christ came, he put the whole puzzle together. And it was a beautiful house. And that house is the house of God, for which he paid the price on Calvary's cross, so that you and I could be his children. Isn't that beautiful? So the second part of the message is not heeded by people, that you must undergo the second birth. Nicodemus couldn't get it. How could a man go into a mother's womb for the second time? And the Lord God Jesus explained to him, no, that which is born of the spirit is spirit. Born of the flesh is flesh. That's why the spirit has to operate in a human being to be born anew, born new. That's why in Christ, all have become a new creation. We are new creatures. The old nature is crucified with Christ. We have been imparted with the divine nature. So we have that Holy Spirit working through us to impart to us the power to exercise our imparted divine nature. Concentrate on it. You are seated in the heavenly places. You and I are seated in the heavenly places. So when we pray, we go to the Lord's presence right away. We worship him. We praise him. We exalt his name. Because we see, like all the angels when they fell at the 7th chapter of the book of Revelation, they praised God, thanksgiving, glory, honor, and praise and all that. They see what is going to happen to the rest of the world when they do not receive Christ as Lord and Savior. So that is the meaning of the message of Christmas on the other part of it. The twofold nature of the birth of Christ or Christmas. So the meaning of Christmas is twofold. If you believe, you are saved. Everlasting life. If you don't believe, you are doomed forever. Isn't that amazing? That is the Christmas message. You know? That is why the Lord is waiting and waiting, allowing the entire human race to celebrate even this Christmas, to realize that Christ was born as a human to die for the whole world. Peace on earth. Goodwill for those who have the goodwill. So they have to receive Christ as Lord and Savior. They are the ones who can have the goodwill to love God and love human race. Isn't that amazing? So we understand from a spiritual perspective the power of the Holy Spirit working in us, those who are born of the Spirit of God. And we have imparted by God Himself the divine nature. And we have to exercise it always. Always we need to go into the Spirit, pray in the Spirit. And as we do that, we can enter into more of the deep things of God. So that is what Christmas reminds me this year. The people we saw last year, they are not here. They are in glory. Christine, Mambro, Vincent Mambro, Arthur. But we are all going to see them. Isn't that amazing? And they are not going to be in hell. We are going to heaven and we are going to see them over there. Like Jesus said, today you will be with me where? In paradise. Christ who takes us. You know. Oh, it is beautiful. Praise the Lord. So, the long and short of the matter for me is, as for everybody is, we need to hear the voice of God. Hear the voice of God. When they did listen, Titanic sunk. They could have avoided it. All that took was 10 minutes. So time and tide are not in our side. Time and tide wait for no man, for no one. That is why the time, Jesus was emphasizing it. How? Repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. The time is near. The time is near. So as we celebrate Christmas as a celebration, great. But the other side of the message is also equally great. Because we are going to escape hell and the everlasting fire. But most of those who do not know Christ as Lord and Savior, they need to come to hear the story of the second birth, which ought to happen. If it doesn't happen, they are in deep trouble. That's why we need to lift up our family, all of them who do not know Christ, or all those who already know Christ. They have more problems than ever before. More problems than ever before, even after receiving Christ. The enemy works against them so much. So much against them, right? We have gone through trials of one kind or the other. Sometimes going through fire. But the Lord always jumped into the fire to save us out of the fire. Sometimes we went through the fire, the Lord was there. We went through the waters. God said, no, it's not going to overflow you. And He protected us. He jumped into our boat to speak to the storm, peace, be still. And He calmed the storm. And the turbulence of the waves stopped immediately in our lives. Because we are bought by the blood. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. God is qualifying us to come closer and closer to Him so that we could be like Him. And taking up the cross daily and following Him becomes a challenge every Christmas time. Even when delivering the Christmas message, I have that ability, I have the opportunity, and I have also the obligation. What is it? To indicate that God loves you.
Hallelujah.
God loves
Praise
you.
God.
That's why He died for you in the form of Christ. But if you don't receive the message, this is what can happen. Now, I don't say that. I don't want that to happen to you. So when we present that message, I think that will have some implication. Someday, I told one person, hey, look, one of these days, when Jesus comes, everybody will have to stand before him, wait through judgment. You know.
Wow.
And if you say that, I never heard the message, you know, what will happen? You know? Christ will bring me into that picture. Lord, I gave him the message at the Dunkin' Donut or someplace. So remember that. That is going to happen. Please think about it. I encourage you to believe. Open your heart to Christ. So we have to plead with them like Apostle Paul was telling us to encourage people. All right, let's go to the Lord in prayer. Lord, we thank you for this Christmas message, O God, that you became human, Lord. Very difficult to understand, but you did become a human. If you didn't, Lord, you could not have died for me and for everybody here and for the world. Lord, receiving your message and Lord, going through this second birth experience, O God, knowing you as Lord and Savior and living for you, Lord God, we see the growth in each one of us and the progress that you are making, O Lord, through your Holy Spirit, drawing us closer and closer to you. We lift up all our loved ones, O God, those whom we are concerned, we prayed for, and some of them came to know you, O God. Others haven't. We pray for them, O God. We lift up your name over everyone that we are concerned about. If they are backslidden, O Lord, we pray for them that they will come back to you, O God. Lord, many came here and received you, Lord, as Lord and Savior. Some of their lives have been in turmoil, O God. We pray for them. Lord, we know many of them in our circular prayer list, O God. They have a struggle going on in their lives. O God, have mercy upon them. If you do not know Christ as Lord and Savior, this is the day you got to know this. God loves you. That is why he took the form of a servant, humbled himself till his death on the cross. He became obedient to death, and he died in your place and in my place as our substitute, as our representative, so that you and I do not have to die and go into that everlasting fire. God loves you. It is a warning so that you could hear the message and be obedient and listen to him. The shepherds listened to the message of the birth of Christ, and they went and saw the baby in the swaddling clothes. They believed the word of God. They believed the message of the birth of Christ. So Christ could be born in you today if you open your heart and receive him as your Lord and Savior, confessing that, Lord, I'm a sinner. Come into my heart. You died for me. Forgive my sins. I receive you as my Lord and Savior. I give everything to you, everything that I am struggling with. Oh, Lord, heal my body. Help me, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. You are my Savior, healer, deliverer, and my peace giver. Everywhere is peacelessness, emptiness, and restlessness. But, Lord, your peace, the peace of God, let it overflow through me. Rule me. Thank you, Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Let's sing the last hymn. Joy to the world. Yes, 125. Thank you. Joy to the world.
Thank you.
goodness of his love, let's pause for benediction. Lord, we thank you for the offering, O God, that we offer ourselves to you, Lord, because you offered yourself to be born in that most horrible situation, in this horrible world, to carry all our sins and sicknesses and diseases on your body. And you got rid of them on the cross. We do thank you, Lord. We are going to be with you for eternity to come. Help us, O God, to spread the message everywhere. Everywhere, O God. Go telling on the mountains, everywhere, O God, that you are going to be the king, and you are already the king, coming to reign soon. Help them, O God, to escape all that is yet to follow, Lord. Let your blessing of peace, power, and presence go with us as we celebrate your birth throughout this day and the rest of the year and the years to come, so that we can continue to praise your name. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Merry Christmas. Have a wonderful celebration. Praise the Lord. Tataji, praise the Lord, yeah!
We daily miss you, and we send your pastor Paul saying, Tataji is coming.
Tataji is coming, he ran at the airport to meet him and you.